Why are you not with the 3-year-old dad?
Her daddy was a one-night stand, and I just happened to get pregnant.
Why not with the 4-year-old dad?
I was with him for 4 years, but he a cheater and a hoe.
All right. What's up, YouTube? It is your boy once again. Back with another episode of Fallery. Kendra G. How do you keep finding these people? Now I give her props. Kendra G is coming along and she is trying to help women. She is really, really trying now. When she first started, I didn't know how it was going to go. But I think she's seen where there's a lot of error going on among the women's side. Our men got our own problems, but the women, it's a little out there. But anyway, she has this young girl she called in, little young girl, 23 years old, and I don't know, Kendra just tried to tell her. She's just trying to tell her. You know, the little girl need help. She just need help. That's all I can say. So I don't want to tell the whole thing, so we're going to let it kick off and let you guys look at it, and, you know, you come to your own conclusions on it. But you know, before we kick it off, y'all know what to do. Go ahead and show your boy support. Hit that subscribe and that notification so you can get the what? The next video. I'll give you a few seconds to do that. Now, let's jump right into this. 23 and angry. That's what.
Hello?
Hello.
Have you been here before?
No, you hung up on me.
Why I hang up on you?
Because as soon as I joined, my volume went low, so I couldn't hear you.
Okay, well, we're back good now. This is the best light you have?
Well, I'm outside.
Okay. What's your name?
Kendra.
Okay. Kendra, where you calling me from?
Texas.
What part?
Wichita Falls.
Wichita Falls. Do you have any kids?
3.
How old are your kids?
7, 3, and 4.
7, 3, and 4, all by the same man?
Mm-mm.
How many men?
Everybody got their own daddy.
Everybody. You get a daddy, you get a daddy, you get a daddy.
We all get a daddy.
You're just stupid for that. So you get a daddy, you get a daddy, you get a daddy.
Akondria, how old are you?
23. Don't look like that.
Baby, girl, what's going on?
Life, running into the wrong people.
Why are you not with the 3-year-old dad?
Her daddy was a one-night stand, and I just happened to get pregnant.
Why are you not with the 4-year-old dad?
I was with him for 4 years, but he a cheater and a hoe.
Okay. Ladies, stop. When they ask you something like that, saying that your baby from a one-night stand, that is not a good look. And then you follow up with the other one's a cheater and a hoe. What the? Man.
And the 7-year-old dad probably was a high school situation. Okay. Akondra, what do you do now for a living, honey?
Well, I work at Walmart.
What's your zodiac sign?
I'm a Leo.
Oh, yeah. This is Akondra, Texas, 3 kids, 23, works at Walmart. What kind of man you looking for, sweetheart?
I'm looking for I'm looking for somebody that is a protector, a leader, a provider. Someone who is understanding, loving. I'm just looking for, I can't really describe it. And I wrote down what I was going to say, but it's in the house and I don't feel like going.
It's in the house.
What Mama are you? Was a Rolling Stone. Y'all funny, but y'all don't get to me. But you can go ahead.
What are your deal breakers?
I don't do cheaters. I don't like men that's addicted to drugs. I don't like liars. Anybody that's still dealing with their baby mama, because I'm a baby mama, so I know how that goes. So I know how women play little games and men play the games too.
Do you still do with your baby daddies?
And
do they pay child support?
Girl, one told me that he'll quit working before he pays child support, so.
So they're not helping you financially with your kids?
Nah, I'll take care of them. I don't trip.
Okay.
It's crazy how they all say that. They come on with that independent mindset. But at the same time, you're on a dating show hoping to meet somebody to help take care of you and these kids. Isn't that something? That's something. Y'all hit me in the comments if y'all know anybody or run across people that talk like this. They independent. They don't need nobody. But it'd be nice to have somebody. Yeah. Hit me in the comments.
Can the guy have kids?
He can.
Do you want more kids?
I do. I want a son.
Do you have all girls?
I have all girls.
Mm-hmm. Kendra, I want you to respond to this because it's definitely going to be a comment if I make you a highlight. What would you say to the guy that's concerned that you have three kids by three different men and you have two kids under five, a 3 and a 4-year-old?
I mean, I don't really know what to say, but I don't deal with my baby daddy, so there's no doubling back on that or worrying about me having to deal with that. I actually don't deal with them at all, so I'm not tied to no other man. Technically, it's just me and them, me and my girls. So,
okay. Does a new guy have to look a certain way?
I've learned that looks ain't all that, so no.
Okay, no. Does he have to make a certain amount of money?
No, just be able to provide for yourself, and me as well, eventually.
Provide for you in what ways?
I do like to be spoiled, so that, I don't need nobody to take care of me because I take care of myself.
Okay, let's do the Kendra cam.
Okay, hold on. Ah, shit, I can't stand it up. I'm outside. Okay, Liz. I have a sports problem.
Okay. So, Kendra, when was your last relationship?
It was about 2 years ago.
Okay.
Hold on. Can I say something? Y'all trying to say I'm 23 with three kids, and y'all mama and grandma's was 20 with like damn near 15, 16 kids, so it really don't matter. Y'all grandmas and all that had 30 damn kids. And y'all worried about me with three kids at 23. Y'all are weird.
Okay, just like I kind of thought. This young lady already tried to have a response back to people. That comment made no freaking sense. What she is trying to say is, your grandparents had kids at 12 and 13 years old. And they would have 12 and 15 kids. But see, these younger people keep going back to their grandparents' times. Those were different times. She could have that many kids like that because she didn't work. She stayed home and took care of the kids. The guy went out and worked. They didn't have daycare back then. Don't people understand? So with you saying this cornball stuff, where your grandparents had all these at 20, I'm this, you effed it all up. Stop trying to go back to your grandparents, their age, their time, and try to explain what you're doing in this time. There's no reason for you to have three kids, three baby daddies right now. There isn't. And none of them taking care of these kids. I can see maybe one, but none of them? No, don't do it. Y'all stop doing this. This generation, y'all need try to find something all the time and just take accountability that y'all messed up. You need to fix it. I'm trying to be on your side a little bit, but I just can't right here. This is stupid. Little girl, get your stuff.
Real weird. And I can be spoiled at 23 by a man. Who don't want to be fucking spoiled by a man that's claimed they want them and love them?
This little girl, well, this woman is childlike in the mind. And I say that because every time she makes statements, she makes these faces. And my nieces and stuff would do it when they were kids. When they say something, they make the little faces and all that stuff. This is a grown woman with three kids, and she doing this. So that tell you where her maturity level is. Like, I...
Want to say anything else?
No.
Okay, cousin. She's ready for that smoke, cousin. She's ready for that smoke. When you said your last relationship was 2 years ago. You don't have to answer. I'm going to ask. When's the last time you was intimate with someone?
About 3 months ago.
Is that person an option?
No.
Why you keep having sex with men you can't stay with in a long-term relationship?
I don't know. Honestly. I think it's the type of men that I attract. Well, not even attract. It's the type that I choose. I be trying to go off looks. And looks really don't be all that.
Yeah, I think you're young. So I always give people, you know, I sit here with life experience. But have you ever gone to therapy to
make I've honestly thought about that, honestly. It's because, I don't know, it's kind of hard for me to talk to people about stuff. But I've honestly thought about that.
Okay. Because I think you might need some guidance on how the decisions you make can affect you for your whole entire life. And, you know, if you continue to have sex with men who you can't build a future with, you know, do you want to have another child with another guy that is going to be a baby daddy?
No, I've already got in my mind that I'm not having no more children until I'm married. And
Okay. So you got to be married. Okay. What are three flaws you think you have to work on, honey?
Three flaws that I think I have to work on. I honestly don't know. You changed up the questions.
No, you don't. You can't think of three things you need to work on.
Not right off the bat of my head.
Let me give you some.
Hold up, Kendra. Hold up. One second. I know y'all say, let it roll, but I'm going to let it roll. It's going to get a little more interesting, too. She's going to go off in a little bit back in off some people. You come on here. Like I said, you trying to have all this stuff set. You changed up the questions. You still don't have an answer. That's one of Kendra's key questions. What are your flaws? And you don't have one? So a lot of these people out here wanting stuff and they never look at themselves and wonder why I get the actions or the reactions that I'm getting from people. Sometimes you got to look in the mirror. And little girl, you need to look hard, man. Hard. Life is not what you think it is. Let's go, Kendra. Hit her with the...
Number one, stop sleeping with men you can't be in committed relationships with. Stop sleeping with men who do not agree to be with you in a committed relationship. Number two, a flaw is always needing men around. I think you should take some time to yourself.
I don't need men around.
Well, you're
I don't always need men around.
So you take me time?
I do. I've been on me time.
How long was your me time?
I've been on me time. Well, if you're talking about the last sexual encounter I had, but before then, I was doing me time for like 2 years. I was in Florida for single for 2 years, and then I moved here.
In those 2 years, did you learn anything about yourself?
Honestly, I didn't take the time to. I was just busy worrying about me and my children and working, trying to provide, honestly.
Okay. Would you date a guy that had three baby mamas?
It really depends on the situation. I can't say yeah and I can't say no. It really depends on where they at with their co-parenting, if they still trying to hunch on each other or if they're actually co-parenting.
Okay. He said he can't have kids. Why would a guy be lucky to be with you, honey?
Because, for one, I'm a great person inside and outside. That's funny. I'm a great person inside and outside. I don't know. Besides that, I don't know.
Never thought about it.
Where's my parents for guidance, babe? I had a mother and a father. They were married. They were in the same household as me. That's where they were. When you're a sheltered child and you're the only sheltered one, you create a sneaky motherfucker. And that's what happened. I was very sheltered. I grew up with nothing but brothers. So my mama and daddy, they sheltered me and kept me inside. So that's where the baby came at 15. Y'all little hoes funny.
You gotta be kidding me. You gonna blame your parents? You gonna blame your parents for sneaking out the house or sneaking somebody in the house when they trying to protect you for the very same thing that end up happening to you? They were trying to protect you from going out and spreading your legs to every little cute boy that you saw in the neighborhood. And you gonna say they created the sneaky MF. God doggone boy. These jokes will blame you for anything. Parents, y'all be ready. Y'all got these small kids. They so cute and shit. This is what they grow up to be. When y'all got them all spoiled and won't tell them to do nothing, this is what happens to them. They turn into one of these. And they'll blame you every time they don't get something or something don't go right. Ask some of these older moms that got these old ass kids out here. These grown kids. Ask them how much they blame them for why their life is messed up. Ask them. This is going to be yours.
Sorry, Kendra.
Okay. And so you had how many brothers?
I have four brothers.
Four brothers. Did they give you the game about men?
Yeah. It was me.
Okay.
It ain't got nothing to do with nobody else. It was me. Young and dumb. That's it. Young and dumb.
So now what did you learn after baby number three? Because it feels like now after baby number three, you've learned some things.
I don't want nobody that just like, if sex is an interest to you right off the bat, I'm not really interested. I have nothing but daughters. So therefore, I'm kind of looking to be loved a little different because I have daughters. So therefore, I have to lead by example for them. Because I'm trying to show them the correct way. I can't have men in and out because I have daughters. I'm the first person they're looking at. I'm not doing all that.
Try this. And everybody gets mad when I say this rule, but it will help you learn the type of man that would be willing to commit with you opposed to just having sex with you. Don't sleep with anybody else who's not willing to be in a relationship with you. What women don't want to talk about enough is women have sexual desires too. Hold on a second. Women have sexual desires too, which is understandable. But women, unlike men at times, want the relationship. Most men can have sex with you and not desire a relationship. So yes, ladies, you're going to have to learn sexual control if you desire a relationship, because you got to figure out who just want to sleep with you and who just want to have sex with you. And what's going to happen is you're going to forever be a person that, I mean, every woman with a vagina, for the most part, you're going to always be able to have sex. Somebody going to sleep with you. May not be the person you want, but somebody on this planet with a penis will sleep with you if you got a vagina. Does not mean they're going to wipe you up and be in a relationship with you. So if there's any first lesson you want to start with, is start with figuring out who will date me and be in a relationship with me versus who will just have sex with me. And the only way that you're going to learn that is if you set the tone and you set the ground rule. So at 23, and this may mean you might go without sex. I am saying that you may go without sex because a lot of men might not want to rise to that occasion and be in a relationship with you. And you're going to have to be okay and stand by that and walk away. But at least you know that he wasn't going to be with you. So that's the first thing you can start doing if you want to start somewhere. Okay. For the person that wants to reach out to you, how can they reach out to you?
My Facebook.
Okay, baby girl.
You didn't even ask me the age range. I don't want no young man.
I forgot that. What's the age range, honey?
I prefer unk them. At least 20. Well, no, at least 30.
So you're 23. You want a man 30 and up?
Yes.
Do you want him to be in Texas?
I don't like it.
Okay.
Yes.
Do you want him to be in Texas?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. He has to be in Texas. All right. And you said money doesn't matter, right? What'd you want to say?
There's times I'm still stuck on my baby daddy of not being on child support. I don't need their money. And y'all worried about the wrong thing. My baby daddy on child support, he just does not pay it. Y'all worry about the wrong thing. Child support is not a factor here.
Let me say this about child support. I think some men got mad when I was talking about this the other day. Child support is about the child. So I don't think the more money you have, the more opportunities you can afford for your child. Money does make life a little bit easier. So shout out to all the women who are bad by themselves and financially truly can take care of their children. But there are women who should seek financial help from the men they had children with. And that's not about you. It's about the child having other more opportunities because there's more income. And I think if more women held men accountable for child support, all these men would not be out here reckless making babies every day. The reason men got 12 kids because 11 baby mamas were like you and wasn't pressing them to pay child support. But I bet you if every time a guy had a child and he had to pay up for that child, he would control how many kids he creates.
Wrong, wrong, wrong. Kendra. See, this is where you're lacking at. Dudes aren't going to pay because they don't think it's their kid. Dudes aren't going to pay because they never going to pay. They ain't never pay for anything. These are sorry dudes. They don't pay for anything. That's why you don't have kids with them. They don't care about going to jail. They going to get right back out. We're seeing these dudes everywhere. That shit that you said that makes no, that will not make them be more responsible because they are irresponsible. That's how that goes.
So I don't think
it's a lot of men. I mean, it's a lot of men that run from working so they don't have to pay child support.
This is true. I mean, listen, the dynamics can be a lot of different ways, but this isn't your first situation. You did this 3 times.
Touché.
Okay. Well, listen, I do have a love for you. Hopefully something was given to you tonight that can help you look at things a little bit differently. But for the guy that wants to meet you right now, what is your Facebook page? All right, sweetheart. Well, you have a good Friday night.
You too.
All right. Bye, sweetheart. You volunteer to open up your legs to this man. So if you have a child by a deadbeat man, it is your fault for choosing to lay with that deadbeat daddy, okay? I know we want to say that nigga ain't shit. I know we want to say, but guess what? He was never shit, and you knew it. So don't start singing that line and that song now when you was a willing participant at one point in time of dealing with a nigga that wasn't shit.
And there it is. She is absolutely right. You fool with someone who ain't crap, you're going to get crap. They're not going to be good fathers because they're not a good person. I don't know why you ladies keep messing with these dudes and all they do is hang out in the streets and then all of a sudden you think they're going to be a good stay-at-home father. No. They don't work that way. But y'all keep doing it anyway. Y'all keep having these kids by these dudes. And then y'all want somebody else to come in or your family members to come in and help you raise all these kids because you can't just stay away from them. Like you said, the ain't shit dudes are always on your mind. So, guys, that's all I got on this. Y'all let me know what y'all think about this. Let me know how many people y'all know in this type of situation think like this little girl. And, you know, man, let's just try to do something out here better. Y'all just do something better. Y'all do something better. All right, guys. Well, that's it for us, man. Let's get up out of here. Make sure you hit that subscribe and that notification and catch the next video. Also, support the channel by becoming a member. Cash App, Super Chat, and Super Thanks. And as always and always, it is your boy, Mr. Nobody. And I'm up out of here. Peace.